what we are doing, we are defining this F1 value, and we are finding its unique values right here. So unique is a function. When you click on this unique, you will find its definition over here. So this is shown right here. So it will give you the values of unique values present in this F1. Okay, so first of all, we will comment the other thing and we will execute only this line, and you will find what it will show you. Okay, so when you click on this df, then you represent inside these bracket as F1, and you are calling this method as a unique. It will give you the array of unique value that will be in the 0 or 1 form. Okay, so you will see this F1 folder right here. So all the values right here in the form of 0 and 1. Okay, so it will provide you the list of unique value. Okay, one is a column which has some values like 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1. These values are present inside this F column. Okay, so how many unique value? This 0 is a unique value and this 1 is a unique value. When you want to show the unique value, you have to use this unique function or method, we can say. So what it will do right here, len, so it will give you the length. Okay, so which length it will provide? This data frame, you have a column F1. F1 is a column. Okay, F1 is a column, and it will give you the length of the unique value of this F1 column. You can execute it. You can see right here, what is the length? Length is 2. There are so many unique value. Okay, there are so many unique value. So it will count those unique values and it will represent those unique values right here. Okay, so there is no repetition right here. You can see 11 point something, 5 point something, NaN is available, 6 point something, and there is no repetition of these fraction values which are represented right here. So this is a data frame, and it will contain the folder, this column F4, and it will provide the unique values. Okay, so how many unique value? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Calculate how many unique values, or you can execute this line. 34. Okay, just execute it. So it is showing 31 unique values. Okay, I think you have not counted. Completed up till this point quickly. Now take the value F1. Okay, count the value of F1. Df F1 value count. How many values are there? For zeros, there are 6041 values. Okay, so let's suppose that this is our column. Okay, and in this column there are number of entries. Okay, there are number of entries, and you have to calculate how many times zero will come and how many times one will come. Okay, so you have to calculate 1, 2, 3, 4, then 1, 2, 3, 4. So it will give you 0 will appear for 4 times and 1 will appear for 4 times. So this is example. Same thing is happening right here. We have F1 column, and inside this F1 column we have to count the values. Okay, how many values are present? So we have two categories. One category is for 0 and another category is for 1. So it will represent those values. So right here in F4, it will give you the value count. How many times that particular thing will appear in complete data set. Okay, so you cannot calculate that thing because this data set is having large number of rows. So you can execute this line of code and you can see right here 5.0 will appear for 1295 times. And you can see right here 28 is shown only for one time. Okay, 27 value is shown for two times. Okay, 17 value shown for 92 times. So in this complete data set, how many times this data will present for that particular number, it is shown right here. Clear to everyone? Quickly give your response. Any doubt till this point? Quickly, all of you, any doubt? Any doubt? Okay, no. So now let's come to next point. Here we have a DF, that is a variable. Okay, DF is a data frame variable. Inside this we are accessing this F1. Okay, this is data frame. F1 is column and head is top values. Okay, top values. So bound method of data frame shows the output. Okay, for this head count. Okay, so it will represent the length of that particular data and the type of that particular data. Okay, so it will show lastly the name as F1. Then it will show the total length of that particular data. Then it will show the type of that particular data. Okay, so next thing is your operators. Here we are using a greater than operator. Okay, so in this greater than operator, what it will do, you can see right here which section is this Indrani, this section Indranil. I cannot find this. Okay, so you can write from here also. I have executed these files for your demonstration. Okay, in the given sheet, this data frame is not available. I think you copy or you can write this code in your notebook. Okay, and write this code in Google Colab and execute it. Okay, if this is not present. So what you will do right here, this is a data frame, and inside this data frame we will access the F4 column. Okay, we will access the F4 column and we will find that how many values are greater than 10. Okay, and we will put NaN where condition is false. So if there is no value, then we will not execute that one. Okay, so this DF is checking the values and checking the shape also. So first we will find the this first option. Okay, then we will find for the shapes. Okay, I will first comment this line and then we will execute the second. Okay, so first you will execute first line. So you can see right here, it will use the complete data frame. it will use the complete data frame starting from 0 to 12,061, and it will use this column 4, okay, and it will show only those value which are greater than 10. Okay, so you can see in this column number 4, only those values will be shown which are greater than 10. Okay, that's why first column row is shown as 0, then second row is shown as 12, third row shown 18. Okay, so in between these rows, this F4 value will be below that particular 11.0. Clear, everyone? So it is showing the output of those values which are more than or greater than 11.0. Clear, everyone? Quickly give your response. Those values which are greater than 11.0, those values are shown right here. Clear? Is it clear to everyone? Now what I will do, I will comment this, and I will create this data frame for the shape which is having greater than 10 value. Okay, so you can see right here, 1965 rows and 8 columns are there for those values which are greater than 10, and it is only showing the shape. Okay, shape means, anyone tell me what is the meaning of this shape? Anyone know about the shape? Shape is showing the data values, okay, in rows and columns. Okay, so how many values are there? Okay, so in the previous execution, it will show the complete data. It will show the complete data which is greater than 10. Okay, now you want the shape of that data. How many columns are there and how many rows are there? Okay, so for that you use the shape. Okay, you use the shape of that particular data. Okay, let's suppose that this is the list 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and this list is assigned to the A variable. And if I will write shape A dot shape, okay, A dot shape, then what it will return? Quickly give your response. What it will return? Quickly give your response. A dot shape. Quickly, but it will return 6, 1. Okay, the shape is represented right here. So how many values are there? This is a list, this is not the table. Only the one single list is available. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 values are there. Okay, so what is the shape of A is equal to 5. Okay, you can execute this code and you will find this shape also. Okay, clear, everyone? Now come to the next point. When you want to display the complete data, what you will do, you will directly write print and put that data variable right here. Okay, and it will show you the complete data information right here. Okay, so when you click right here, you will see this complete data. Okay, so correlation, when you want to find out the correlation between first line to the second line, or we can say first column to the second column, it will show the correlation using this CORR function. Okay, so this complete data frame is DF, and this DF dot correlation is represented right here. So you can see this diagonal is showing the maximum correlation, that is 1, whereas other values are below this. Okay, correlation relation between one to another column is called a correlation. Okay, how much value? Okay, let's suppose that this value, I will explain you right here. Okay, let's suppose that there is some this is a graph of your values. Okay, so how much values are moving toward this side or toward this side? Okay, let's suppose that this is the maximum correlation right here. This is one correlation. Either it is increasing, that is plus sign, or it is decreasing, that is minus sign. So that correlation, if you want to draw, you have to represent this diagonal right here. So these values, F2 values of this particular F7 having the maximum correlation with F7. Okay, so F7 having some values, like let's suppose that F7 is having one value. Okay, so in both the ways, this F7 column has a maximum correlation. You can see that from here. Okay, then F3 to F7, how much variation is there? So you can see this is the value F3 and F7. So you take the difference right here and put that value right here. So this is the correlation. You have to differentiate from this one. Okay, what is the value of this F4 correlation? You can represent right here. Okay, what is the correlation value for this F7 to F5? You can represent right here.